find, if you read military history and history in general, that the stories that were told are stories of hubris, ambition, and failure in the end. Adolf Hitler, Chairman Mao in some ways, George Custer, all throughout history. You go all the way back to ancient times, all right? The Greeks were very keen on describing hubris. And watching this episode of Mandalorian made me remember what hubris means in ancient Greek. Pretensions to the gods. And Moff Gideon is a very pretentious person. He's pretentious, and he is ambitious, and he's hubris-filled. And hubris usually ends up being the end of the person with the hubris problem. And I think, and this is what I think John and Dave are doing, they've got a collision course going on between Gideon and the true leader of the Imperial Navy and the Imperial sector, this guy right here. If you look at Gideon, he is dressed almost like Vader, black armor with insignia on it and different, almost looks like lights. A helmet that looks slightly Mandalorian, but also gives you the feeling of Darth Revan. And Vader. Gideon truly believes he is the next leader and heir to the Empire after the death of the Emperor and Vader. And he is accumulating their trappings. The problem with this is that he is not intellectually sound enough or smart enough to actually take control of the situation. I'm watching what's going on here. I'm going to watch the episode again. And to me, it seems he's moving too fast. Pelleon looks at him like, what? When he starts digging at Grand Admiral Thrawn, the rest of them are weaker than he is, but they're not as strong as Thrawn is. And Thrawn is the true power here, not Gideon. And Gideon, because Thrawn isn't there, thinks that, well, Thrawn doesn't care, I'm going to take over. That's not how it goes. Pelleon will go. He's on the Chimera, which is what Thrawn's actual ship, which is a Star Destroyer, is called. And he's going to tell Grand Admiral Thrawn that, sir, Moff Gideon wants this, 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 and this. Grand Admiral Thrawn is going to go, oh, Captain Pelleon, well, our Moff is a rather hubristic, ambitious fellow, don't you think? Does he actually think he is the heir to the Empire? Does he think he's the new leader? Let us see where he goes with this. Now, I also think Thrawn is going to raise the question of, you moved too quickly. You got the attention of the New Republic. And Thrawn is not going to be pleased with that at all. The reason why he doesn't appear when Gideon thinks he should is because he is secrecy itself. He understands what the secrecy is. Okay? He understands that the less we see of him, the better for him and his plans, which are to return the Empire to glory, okay? And Thrawn is not stupid. Let's put it this way. If they didn't play chess, if they were playing chess, Thrawn will be the grandmaster chess player. The less we see of him, the less his own imperial lieutenants see of him, in the case of the meeting in the show just now, the better for his ambitions. Because you cannot let what your real plans are, your real intentions, be known to anybody else but your inner circle. And Pelleon is one of them, which is why he had that look on his face of, oh, you've got to be kidding. Oh, just wait till I tell the Grand Admiral. I have a feeling Dave and John have set up a collision course between Thrawn and Gideon, and Gideon is going to basically be the odd man out. You can't really have two people vying to lead the Empire when one is basically twisting his mustache like your typical villain, and the other one is acting like the man behind the shadows, the man you can't see, the man that's intelligent enough to stay out of the mainstream conversation. The reason why he doesn't show up to meetings and sends Pelleon is because if by chance any of these lesser light imperial captains, admirals, moffs get captured and spilled the beans, his plans would not be able to go into fruition, okay? That's the thing about Thrawn, and Gideon doesn't seem to understand that kind of strategy. It's sort of like The Godfather. Don't ever tell anybody outside the family what you're thinking. To Captain Pelleon, Pelleon, never discuss our plans with anyone outside our circle. Anyone meaning the other Imperials, okay? Because what they are is a pimple on the ass of progress, okay? They're pirates, they're doing stuff for their own ambition, and Gideon can talk about reclaiming the Empire all he wants, but when you look at what he's doing, it's all for himself. Okay, that's not what a conqueror, that's not what a man, a true intellectual warrior does. Okay, and he is going to run afoul of Grand Admiral Thrawn, and Grand Admiral Thrawn will chew him up and spit him out. Okay, those two are on a collision course, and I have a feeling we're going to see the Chimera and maybe even see Grand Admiral Thrawn at the end of this season. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.